Leading the team was Godfrey Kayemba Solo, the Member of Parliament of Bukoma Nsimbi South, who also doubles as Shadow Minister for Sports, who expressed his concerns during a press briefing at Parliament, where he welcomed the proposal to redevelop Lugogo Cricket Oval, but called for full disclosure of the agreement signed between government and the Turkish investor.
We want to know what's in the contract, the agreement between the investor and Uganda government. What's their role? What's the government getting, giving there? And what's the investor getting? What's the investor giving us? We want to know the full details of that agreement. We don't want to see the same incidences that have happened.
Kayemba cited examples of Shimon Demonstration School land that was taken away in guise of constructing a hotel during the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in 2007, but was later given to businessman Sudhir Ruparelia to build Kingdom Mall, and now government is paying him for rent, among other examples.
We have seen many incidences where land has been given to investors to develop and we end up losing that land. We have many examples. We have Aya, where UTV was. Actually, up to now, it's on sale right now. We have Shimon, which was given away. Promise that a person is going to come and develop there. We see offices there. We see Nachivubo Stadium.
Members of Parliament decried increased loss of public land for sports and recreation facilities and called for an audit across the country to establish the extent of the loss.
We have to go deeper to the districts and find out if the land allocated for the sports fraternity is still existing. So this campaign must go beyond the national to the district level. We find out, for example, I come from Mpiji, but there is no grounds for sports in Mpiji district.
We are worried what will happen to that stadium because we don't have the agreements, which agreements are supposed to have been made by the government and the investor. If you read today's newspapers, I think the Monitor or the New Vision, Aya is on sale. I want you to note that there are speculators in this country. That man who came to develop Aya made the money and he left Aya alone and he went because he had made his difference.
They also asked government for an update on the development of Akibua Stadium in Lira, which was one of the grounds included in the bid by Uganda to host the 2027 Africa Cup of Nations.
The redevelopment of Akibua Stadium in Lira was one of the issues that were raised in Uganda's bid to host AFCON in 2027. So we'd like to know what the regime is doing, an update on the redevelopment of that stadium, because we are in 2023.
This AFCON is, I think, 2 years to come.
4 years
to come. I don't know whether in 4 years they would have developed. I saw a certain building, I think it is in that stadium, Achibua Stadium. A funny building, it is like a toilet of some kind, a poor man's toilet. And they said that poor man's toilet in there, which they call a pavilion, costed 500 million.
The opposition are demanding the Minister of Sports to come to Parliament and explain the full details to the nation about the contents of the agreement. And if he fails, they want Parliament to institute a special committee to investigate that matter.
We want to see a detailed contract of Lugogo Cricket Oval and the Turkish investor. Want the minister to come and explain the full details to the nation. If he fails, we'll ask the parliament, at least the speaker, to put up a special committee to investigate that matter, instead of dealing with the post-mortem when all is gone.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.